trending news. Have some shame and save what is called integrity. Renu Omokri blasts Soyinka. Renu Omokri, the man that refused to stop talking and one of the president's Muhammadu Buhari's top critics, has once again spoken again. This time around, he decided to shift his criticism to the Nobel laureate Prof. Wole Soyinka. He stated that Prof. Wole Soyinka should have some shame and save what is left in his integrity. He made this statement based on what Wole Soyinka said recently concerning this present government after telling Nigerians to support President Muhammadu Buhari when he came to power 5 years ago. Renu Omokri made this disclosure on a Twitter he made on his verified Twitter handle this evening. He went further to upload what Prof. Wole Soyinka wrote 5 years ago, telling Nigerians to forgive President Muhammadu Buhari and give him the needed support. Here is what he wrote. Nigeria must forgive President Muhammadu Buhari's past, Lauren Soyinka says. Africa's first Nobel Lauren Soyinka for Literature said that Nigerians must show a Nelson Mandela-like ability to forgive President Muhammadu Buhari elect President Muhammadu Buhari's past as an iron-fisted military ruler. This was the tweet he made blasting Professor Wole Soyinka. Have some shame. Save what is left of your integrity. Stop lamenting over General Muhammadu Buhari. You knew quite well what he was like. You even begged Nigerians to forgive him. And now that the leopard is revealing its spots, you say you are disappointed. Who voted for him and who pleaded to Nigerians to vote for him? So you don't need to beg, or you don't need to be disappointed over what you caused for yourself. Renu Omokri was a former special assistant to former President Goodluck Jonathan on media and publicity. He was a strong supporter of former President Goodluck Jonathan, and in recent days, he has condemned President Muhammadu Buhari's led government and has kept on doing that because of his outspokenness. Thank you, viewers, for listening to this news. Wow, I said it before, and I'll keep saying it, that the Yorubas were the one who voted for President Muhammadu Buhari. They should not regret it. When Buhari was coming in as a president, they were so much happy. They were jubilating that they come rain, come shine, they would definitely vote for President Muhammadu Buhari. That no matter what happens, they would definitely vote for him and nothing would change that. Wole Soyinka also begged Nigerians to vote for President Muhammadu Buhari in 2015, which they did, which they surrendered all he had to President Muhammadu Buhari for him to be able to emerge the winner then in 2015 as the president of Nigeria. So now I see no reason why Wole Soyinka should be biting his finger. Nobody sent him. Now he's regretting and telling President Muhammadu Buhari that he's so much disappointed. He should not be disappointed because he caused everything and made President Muhammadu Buhari where he is now. He made him sit on the throne of leadership. So he should not be disappointed. He should not see any negative things about President Muhammadu Buhari because he put him there. The Yorubas put him there. I met a Yoruba man that was really lamenting, saying that he regretted ever voting for President Muhammadu Buhari. That if he had known, they would have left Goodluck Jonathan to continue ruling. They said the angel you know is better than the angel you don't know. That's the adage. That's the real adage. President Muhammadu Buhari is an angel, while Goodluck Jonathan is a devil. So the devil you know is better than the angel you don't know. They voted for him and now they are complaining. They should not complain because this is what they deserve. Some people are so myopic. So if he supported President Muhammadu Buhari, doesn't he have the right to criticize him? Or is President Muhammadu Buhari God that cannot make mistakes? Or must they always agree on every issues? Or mockery, that is busy writing. He has said the truth. He said what Wole Soyinka says, that he is so disappointed in President Muhammadu Buhari with the way he's handling the issue of the country. When Wole Soyinka and others fought the battle that brought Goodluck Jonathan into power even before the death of Yar'Adua, who pressured the National Assembly to initiate the doctrine of government of necessity. Who did that? So, haven't fought for the installation of Goodluck Jonathan's government, he is more than qualified to also criticize the government. Besides, he is a senior citizen who has paid his due to the nation. He has the right to criticize any government. It does not mean he is right all the time, but right now, or he might be right or wrong, no one should try to silence him, and definitely not clown. So, as I've said before, Wole Soyinka should not be disappointed. Wole Soyinka should not be embarrassed, because they made President Muhammadu Buhari, they supported him, and he became the president of the country. So regretting and being disappointed is not the issue. The issue now is that President Muhammadu Buhari is already on the seat. Then we should be looking for solution. A lasting solution at that, that will make all this mess, that will make all these things happening in the country to vanish, or to disappear. Not regretting and being disappointed for voting President Muhammadu Buhari. The election has gone and gone forever. How many years from now? We are in 2020, 5 years ago. So why bring in this issue? I regretting of ever voting for President Muhammadu Buhari. They voted for President Muhammadu Buhari already, and he has become the president in the country. And look at what is happening. A lot of people are regretting, fine. But they should not regret anymore. They should not complain anymore. The issue now and the solution to all these calamities, all this crisis in this country, is to come together and agree on how to deal with these insurgents in this country. The President Muhammadu Buhari is really worsening issue. He doesn't want to release these people. He said that if they have been caught killing, that they should not be killed. He should not revenge. They should bring them over to him. Then he will decide what to do to them. Imagine that. If Buhari can make up his mind to destroy these people, to persecute these people, immediately they are caught. And they should be persecuted. Before you know it, we'll definitely catch all the rest ones that are hiding in different communities. Then they will all be apprehended and be persecuted. And before you know it, Boko Haram, they will never be Boko Haram or X-Men in Nigeria anymore. Well, look, Jonathan has really tried. He tried when he was still still as the president of the country. He struggled to fight and destroy Boko Haram. He tried a lot, but they did not allow him to continue with his struggle. They quickly took him out of the way by voting him and voting President Muhammadu Buhari. They thought that President Muhammadu Buhari will be in the best position to tackle all this issue. But you never knew that President Muhammadu Buhari even or will even worsen the issue more than it has been before. So viewers, I don't have much to say concerning this. Your comment is very much needed. Drop them below the comment box, click on the subscription buttons as well as the bell button to receive updates whenever I publish new videos. And don't forget, share and like this news as well.